Hey everyone, I'm Mr. Willis, and this is your Macro Minute on Expansionary Monetary Policy. Expansionary monetary policy is also known as easy monetary policy. It's used when the economy is in a recessionary gap, and real GDP output is being produced at too slow a rate, causing excessive unemployment. When the central bank implements expansionary monetary policy, it intends to stabilize the economy and stimulate aggregate demand in order to accomplish the goals of boosting real GDP output and eliminating cyclical unemployment. Expansionary monetary policy can be visualized by a rightward shift of the aggregate demand curve, which leads to an increase in both price level and real GDP output. It can also be visualized by a leftward movement along the short-run Phillips curve, which represents an increase in the inflation rate and a decrease in the unemployment rate at the same time. The central bank has four expansionary policy options: decrease the discount rate, decrease the reserve ratio, buy bonds in the open market, or decrease the federal funds rate. Each of these policies will increase the money supply and drive down nominal interest rates, which makes loans less expensive and stimulates investment spending by firms across the economy. The boost in investment spending will inject income into the economy and stimulate a multiplier effect of consumer spending, which will boost aggregate demand, create job opportunities, and stimulate real GDP growth. This growth should close the recessionary gap that exists and return the economy to full employment. However, expansionary monetary policy will also cause demand pull inflation. This leads to a decrease in real wages, as each dollar earned by workers has less purchasing power. It also leads to a decrease in net exports, as foreign consumers buy fewer exports because they're now more expensive. Thank you so much for watching. That's expansionary monetary policy, and this has been your Macro Minute.